Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, we'll take a look at making a music lyric video, also known as kinetic typography. Now, this could be done with the titles built into Final Cut Pro, but you can do this much faster and make it look much better with a plugin. The one I'm using in this example is the new Ultimate Titles pack for Final Cut Pro and Apple Motion from Digital Products 669, who sponsored this video. This pack includes over 200 items in 9 categories, including modern, minimal, broadcast, retro, and more. All the titles used in this tutorial are from this plugin. I'll leave a link for it in the video description below. Now let's jump right into Final Cut Pro and take a look at how it's done. Down in my timeline, I have a music track with markers placed on the first few lines of the song. The song I'm using for this example is called You'll Be On My Mind by Wakeup, downloaded from Epidemic Sound. I'll also leave a link to it in the video description. To start, place your playhead on the first marker and head up to the Titles and Generators browser. After downloading the titles pack I mentioned before, scroll down and select the Ultimate Titles pack and find the Kinetic category. For our first line, I think the Kinetic 13 title would fit great. Select it and press Q to connect it to your timeline. Place your playhead at a point where the text is fully revealed, head up to the inspector, and make sure the titles inspector is selected. This is where you can adjust the appearance of your title. You can change any of the colors, enable or disable the animations, remove the title background, and more. To save some time, we'll leave most of these settings at default and only adjust what's necessary. I'll select the text 1 box and enter my text. The scale and position look fine, so I'll move on to text 2 box. I'll enter my text and adjust the scale so the size lines up with this line. Right about there. I'll do the same for boxes 3 and 4. This is what our title looks like so far. As you can see, the timing doesn't quite line up with the song, but we'll adjust that later. I'll place my playhead on the second marker, add another title, change the text, and adjust the appearance if necessary. As you can see, the text in line 1 doesn't quite fit in the box. We can change the text size, or a better alternative in this case, adjust the box size. Just above the text 1 box, you'll see a shape width slider. Drag this to the right until your text fits in the box. Let's also change the scale of our last line and adjust the position by changing the offset values. I'll go through and add a different title from this category to every line in my song, change the text, and if necessary, adjust the appearance. Now, let's retime these titles to match up with our lyrics. As many of you already know, you can't retime title clips in Final Cut Pro. To get around this, select each title clip and make it into a compound clip by pressing Option G. Disable the top 4 clips by command clicking them and pressing V on your keyboard. Next, move your bottom clip to the start of your timeline. With your playhead on the first frame, press Shift H on your keyboard to add a frame hold. Click and drag the handle at the end until it's almost at your first marker. With this clip still selected, press Command G to make it a connected timeline. Blade your clip at the end of your hold frame and right before the third warp comes in. Select the middle segment and press Command R to bring up the retime menu. Play your song and stop the playhead right where the third warp starts. Now click and drag the retime handle to speed up the selected segment. The last two warps come in at the right time, so we'll move on to the second clip. Select your second clip and press V to re-enable it. Play through your project and see if you need to adjust the timing. This one actually looks pretty good, so let's move on to the next one. Re-enable a clip, make another connected timeline, and retime the clip if necessary. Do the same to the rest of your clips. Your finished project should now look like this. The the ultimate title spec from Digital Products 669, makes making these videos fun and easy. And like I mentioned at the start of this video, it includes over 200 items for some fun and unique animated titles. If you're interested in trying it out, I'll leave a link for it in the video description below. And a big thank you to Digital Products 669 for sponsoring this video. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, and if you haven't yet, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.